हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू एस आर कॉन्सेप्ट्स। आई एम रवि वर्मा एंड इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस द क्रॉप प्रोडक्शन मैनेजमेंट। सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन इंडिया देर आर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ फार्मर्स डिपेंडिंग ऑन देयर इकोनॉमिक स्टेट। सो देर आर सर्टेन फार्मर्स हु आर वेरी पुअर एंड देर आर सर्टेन फार्मर्स हु आर वेरी रिच। So depending on the type of input, the cost which they are the amount of money that they are investing in the crop production, or depending upon the purchase capacity, there are three types of crop productions. One is no cost production, where the farmer is not spending or is spending very little amount of money, and his purchase capacity for the different types of instruments and resources is very less. While on the other hand, there is a low cost production, where this is a type of production in which a farmer has medium level of economic efficiency, or his purchase capacity is medium, and he is investing a little amount of money here. But what about high cost production? In this kind of production, the farmer is putting a lot of money and using a number of different equipments, a number of different resources for increasing the yield of the crop. So as you will go down, means there, if you will see that the yield is maximum in high cost production and minimum in no cost production, right? So dear students, so now let's understand the nutrient management. Dear students, as you know that when the plants are growing in the soil, what happens that the plants are absorbing a number of elements, a number of nutrients from the soil. So gradually these elements may deplete in the soil. So you will have to manage the nutrients in the soil. So first of all, let's learn about the nutrients. Here students, you can see there are two tables which are showing the different nutrients which are required for the plants. For example, carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium and calcium. These are required in a little bit larger amount and they are called macro elements. But these elements, sulfur, boron, chlorine, copper, iron, manganese, molybdenum, these are required in very little amount, including zinc. Right, so these are called micronutrients. So dear students, you have to learn these 16 nutrients, right? Which one are macro and which one are micronutrients. So you have to learn these lists also. Here you can see this table is also given in your NCERT textbook. So the source of carbon and oxygen is air, and the source of hydrogen and oxygen is water, and the source of macronutrients and micronutrients are actually the soil. These are actually the 13 nutrients which are obtained from the soil, and these are 3 nutrients which are given from air and water. So dear students, in order to maintain the different types of nutrients in soil, we generally add fertilizers and manures. So dear students, there is something written, what happens if plants lack in these nutrients? The yield may be affected, as plants wouldn't be able to reproduce, and the plant growth can be affected. Plants can get diseased easily, so their immune system will, means immunity will be weakened, we can say, or they will get diseases very fastly. So dear students, here you can see how can we increase the yield by providing all nutrients to the plant. So if we want to provide nutrients to the plants, we can use manures, right? So how to use manure? Manure is prepared by using animal excreta and plant waste. These animal excreta and plant waste are the dead organic materials. When they are decomposed, they convert into the manure. So generally we take a pit, when we make pits in the ground, and we cover them with the soil, and finally these organic wastes get decomposed and convert into the manure. This process is called composting. So what are the functions or features of manure? The manure mainly contain organic material which is partially decomposed and which increases fertility of the soil. It also contains nutrients in a small quantity which are then supplied to the soil on adding manure. The soil structure is also enhanced by the use of manure. It increases water hold, it tends to hold more amount of water. That means it will improve the water holding capacity of the plant, of the soil. If the soil is sandy, then it will increase the water holding capacity. But if the soil is clay, it will decrease the water holding capacity. So in this way, in the clay soil, it will prevent the waterlogging situation. So what is written here? Organic matter avoids waterlogging condition and improves the drainage in the clay soil. It improves the drainage but removes the waterlogging condition in the clay soil. Waterlogging condition is a condition in which the water is filled in the soil so much that there is no space between the pores of the between the particles of the soil. No empty space, because in every space there will be water only. Now the manure is purely organic, hence using more manure is completely healthy for plants as well as the environment. So you will see that the fertilizers may cause pollution, but the manure will not cause pollution. Using manure is a way to recycle the farm waste. We can recycle the farm waste by using the manure. So what is composting? Composting is a process of making manure. The process of recycling the farm waste material by decomposing is called composting. The product formed on decomposition of the organic material is called compost, or it is also called manure. Compost has a high variety of nutrients and organic matter. The material used in preparation of compost are animal excreta, sewage waste, vegetable waste and weeds. You can see all types of biological wastes can be used for composting, but generally we avoid using animal wastes, right? So dear students, the composting can be done either without using worms. If you are making a compost without using worms, then it is called compost. But if you are using the worms for making manure, then it is called vermi compost. What is written, you can see. A manure prepared from waste materials such as cow dung, sewage, vegetables, waste and domestic waste, it is called compost. A manure that is prepared by using earthworm, means earthworm is used along with this material, then it is called vermicompost. Here you can see, you can read a little bit more about it. It takes around 3 to 6 months, but it takes only 1 to 2 months for the formation. That means earthworms or redworms will increase the speed of decomposition and formation of manure. What is written? The microbes decay the manure and manure is formed. The earthworm reduce the matter and compost is formed. Next, you can see green manure. What is green manure? Green manure, you will see there are certain plants which are grown and then plowed again in the soil. So there are certain plants which you will grow in the soil and then plow them in the soil. These plants will decay and turn into manure, which enrich the soil mainly with nitrogen and phosphorus. Plants that are used in the production of green manure are hemp, clover, peas and grass mixtures. So dear students, you can see these are certain plants which are grown in the field and then mulched with the soil, mixed with the soil or plowed inside the soil before sowing the actual crop plants. Now dear students, we will see what is the use of fertilizers. You can see that fertilizers are chemicals, right? For example, organic fertilizers which are used by farmers are limestone and rye phosphates, and artificial fertilizers which are produced in industries, they are ammonium nitrate and potassium sulfate. But as these are chemicals, they may be very harmful to the environment, and then they may also pollute the soil, they may also destroy the soil. But if you will use manure also along with the fertilizers, then they will become less harmful to the soil. So you will see, fertilizers provide important nutrients such as nitrogen, phosphorus, right, and potassium to the soil. They help in proper growth of the plant and they are responsible for high yield in the high cost farming methods. Here you can see how a farmer is applying fertilizers to the field. So there are certain precautions that you should use while using fertilizers. So fertilizers should be applied in a proper amount, and an excess of fertilizer is not good for plants as well as for the environment. Now, proper precautions regarding the time of applying fertilizers should be taken. So when to be used and how much to be used, this need to be taken care of. Next, Excess use of fertilizers can lead to water pollution, and extra fertilizers get washed away during the irrigation process into the water bodies and into the underground water. Then excess use of fertilizers can also destroy the fertility of the soil. Why? Because excess use of fertilizers will kill microbes, and if the microbes will be killed, they will not perform nitrogen fixation, and in this way the fertility of the soil will decrease. So dear students, how are fertilizers and manures different from each other? This table shows this, right? So manures provide humus, but fertilizers do not provide humus. Manures are less rich in nutrients, but fertilizers are very rich in nutrient, right? They have long term good effects, but they have if you will using them for the long term, then they will suddenly decrease the fertility of the soil. Another difference is that manure is very slowly absorbable, but fertilizers are absorbed very easily because fertilizers are soluble in water. In the next video, we will discuss what is organic farming. Thanks a lot for watching the video. Prepare your notes and learn each and every topic properly. Thank you.